Dear teacher, good morning. How many of you struggles with the concept of students' engagement? Many teachers in the classroom as well struggle with this. A lot of students, they do not pay attention of what you are saying as a teacher. And we are asking ourselves, what would be the reason of this? The reason of this, I will give you briefly introduction today about what you can do to fix this problem in your classroom. So normally we follow traditional way of teaching in the classroom, which started with lesson plan, as you see here, traditional approach, lesson plan. And then lesson plan, you prepare it as a teacher before you come into the classroom. You ask it to do it for evaluation purpose, for advisor purpose. And not many teachers keep going or keep doing it, in fact. And then you come to the classroom giving lecture, normally. And the lecture might be not interesting, might be boring for students. A lot of students drop out. Nobody pay attention about this. And then you give homework after the classroom. And by the end of the course, you give students final exam. So this is a traditional model of teaching a lot of teachers follow nowadays. This model actually based on external or extrinsic motivation of students, that students go to study because they need the grades, they need the mark by the end of the course, but they do not like what they are doing because we didn't provide for them this. So in this lecture, I will provide for you completely new model of teaching, which is based on innovative approach of education now, of learning, that we called it flip the classroom. This model actually encourage students' intrinsic motivation, and intrinsic motivation that students like, believe, have positive attitude with what they are doing in general, and they like, they want to do because they like to do it. So they have sort of, self-control and self-motivation. So this model, actually, I would like to focus and highlight today for many teachers with us today. So it's called learning portfolio. So learning portfolio, it's sort of a purposeful collection of students' work, students' achievement, progress, evidence of learning that students can collect it. And actually, it's not only for students, can be for teacher as well. So if you ask your teacher, for example, if you are a principal and they ask your teachers, or the dean and they ask your teachers, or the head of the department to ask your teacher to make lesson plan, teacher doesn't know exactly what is the value behind lesson plan. It's from control point of view, for you it's good evidence to see if the teacher is doing well. But for teachers themselves, they don't know exactly what's the value behind a lesson plan for them. But if I ask the teacher in different way, could you please build up your learning or teaching portfolio during the semester? So when semester will be finished, so you will come up with the whole experience that you have done with your students, and you provide for us what it may work and what it didn't work actually during your sessions. And you could share this knowledge, you could create and produce new knowledge based on this as well. This is what I'm talking today about, learning portfolio. So learning portfolio is the new concept for it is basically sort of evaluation for students and as well sort of self-reflection for the teachers themselves. It can be as well new way of learning that basically focus on learning needs, and the learner by himself, by herself, follow individual path of learning, in which they can follow up, develop their curiosity, and as well encourage them to see the weak and strength points they have to manage it. So when we are talking about, student-centered learning, so the concept here is might be significant to use. So learning portfolio, if you use it, prepare it before even classroom, before even start your semester. But all of learning activities, which should be, you can even record short video of your lecture, key lecture, let us say, and put it online. Allow students to go to watch it before coming to the classroom. And when students come to the classroom, they do what we are seeing here, learning activities. They do something completely different than lecture, different than listening. It's about interacting together, make sort of meaningful activities inside the classroom, face-to-face activities in which you can interact as human being. And this is the big deal of learning nowadays, when you interact with the person, interact with the group, learning how to communicate, how to collaborate, how to negotiate. All of this is really the skills we need nowadays for our students. So, and then after you finish your classroom, students will be more interested in the topic. So you open for them the door for more learning. They build up their curiosity for learning. They would like to learn more and more and more, even without you pushing, without you that you tell them all the time. It doesn't matter anymore because you already cultivate the culture of learning in your students' brain. So this is what we are needing. So the point is how to change students' attitude. And neuroscience, this is a new field of science which is responsible about brain function. We learn from them that the part of attitude, the part of feeling in the human brain dominate the part of memory and the part of cognitive function in a way that students cannot learn until they are happy and they are internally motivated. They like what they are doing. If you cultivate this culture, students are more willing to learn and learn based on their needs. So this is remains or last for longer. So this is what I want to say today is think twice. Instead of going with traditional way, which already destructive way, doesn't bring any more students engagement, doesn't bring any more fun and enjoyment in the classroom, rather than think about flipped classroom and learning portfolio. Prepare all of your material once before semester start, and then go through it. Think about design thinking, or think design, in which you can design different activities in the classroom, face-to-face activities, in order to increase, enhance students' engagement and students' curiosity to learning. And this is what we call innovative approach. So this is briefly was my message to you today, is think about changing the traditional approach you are following in the classroom into new approach, which is based on learning portfolio and flipped classroom. So next lecture or next messages, I will highlight more and more and give you practical example how to design learning portfolio and prepare for flipped classroom for your professional classes in your school or in your college. So this is my message to you today. Think for changing from traditional concept into an innovative concept where learning portfolio and the flipped classroom take place.